guys, this is your girl Wakeji Kamore, and welcome to Reflections by Wakeji Kamore. More like 4 months since the last time I was here. So welcome back to my channel. This is where I share my life. This is where I share my love for God and my love for you guys, as you watch and listen to me. And this is where I share the word of God in the simplest form possible. So this welcome actually goes also to me, because I mean, after such a long time since the last time I was here, I need to welcome myself back. So welcome, Wakeji. Welcome back, Wakeji. And again, welcome to my lovely, lovely listeners and watchers. Can someone say that? So anyway, since the last time I was here, so many two things have happened in my life. Some bad stuff, but mostly good, great stuff. And I'm totally, totally thankful to God for that. And I do hope that you're also thankful to God for the things that have happened in your life. I hope that you have missed me, because I have missed being here and I've missed you guys. And it's so good to be back. I'm so glad to be back. So one of the headaches for coming back to shoot videos is not knowing where to pick up. So now I keep wondering, so do I continue with the story that I had last time, or do I just linger that whole story and start afresh? Like, that has been my headache. But something happened last week that, you know, kind of shed a light on what I should do next, or what kind of video I should shoot next. So if you remember the last video that I did, I was in a really ugly space. I was in a space where I had given a fundi some work to do for me, and I had given him a lot of money as deposit, and he did not deliver the job. And I was struggling with anger. I was actually struggling with anger. I was struggling with, you know, forgiveness, and how does that look like? Actually, if you haven't watched that video, I'm going to put the link in the description box, so that you can go and watch that video. You can actually pause this and go watch that one, because this is going to be a continuation of that story. So I would like to continue that story. I know at the end of the last video, I said that I would actually want to invite somebody to come and, you know, just explain to us how forgiveness looks like. Because at that time, I was wondering really how forgiveness looks like. But I realized, you know what? This is a journey that I'm going on, that I was on, and I would actually find the answers for the things that I was questioning in that journey. So today is actually the continuation of that story. It's a continuation of what happened. So did the guy pay me? So what happened? Did I let it go? You know, just that story. Again, I have my laptop here, because me, I don't want to pretend that I remember everything. So a quick recap. If you remember the last video that I did, I had given a fundi. I was decorating a house for someone. I was decorating a furnished apartment for someone. And I had given some deposit to a fundi. A fundi is, for people who don't know what a fundi is, a fundi is a carpenter who was supposed to do the woodwork for furniture, for some bedside tables, the dining table, coffee table, TV stand. There was a lot of work that was involved. So there was a lot of money that was going to be given as deposit. So I gave that, and the guy didn't deliver. And then the guy started doing those hide and seek things with me in Gikomba, and it was just a rough time, let me tell you. It was a rough time, because now the client had to give more money to buy new furniture, because now this guy is not delivering. And I was struggling with anger. I was struggling with, so should I pursue legal justice? Should I just let it go? I mean, how does forgiveness look like? So does forgiveness mean that you stop feeling angry? Because really, I was angry, you guys. I was really angry. So what happened is that by the time I was doing that video, I had actually already started pursuing legal justice. So what happened is I went to the Mkunji and reported the matter, and the cops tried as much as possible to catch the guy. But he was so like smart. So every time we would go to arrest him, he would be tipped off by either a colleague, or someone would just tip him off, so we wouldn't find him there. Of course, I mean, let me say, cops are smart. And also that crown that is on their kofia carries a lot of power. I think that's one of the things that I learned about our, I don't know how to call it, the legal system. I don't know, like cops basically. So what happened is that the cops are really street smart. So we kind of figured out how to arrest the guy, and we arrested him finally on one night in a very dingy dark club. So we had gotten wind that he would be in that club. We got someone to even tell us where he was seated and what color of shirt he was wearing. And because I needed to be the one who identified him, I needed to go to the club. Should have seen me in that club. It was so dark. It was like past curfew hours. It's in the middle of Gikomba and it's dark and dingy. And I had to go in there and identify the guy and say it is him. So I went up there. I think I was the only chick in that club. And I remember feeling so out of place, because there are so many men, and most of those men are men who actually work in Gikomba. So I went, I saw him, I walked straight to him, and I gotard him. Okay, gotard, you gotard with the right. So I gotard him, and no sooner had I gotard the guy than he had been cuffed. Finally, I've used that English, I don't even know what they're called, those things used to be taught in high school, in primary school. So the guy was cuffed. I gotard him and he was cuffed. I kind of felt like Judas, you know, like the way Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss. I felt like I betrayed this guy with a gota. But anyways, he was cuffed. And I remember his friends trying to talk to me and telling me to let it go, to let the money go. And I remember I was so mad at that specific point. The only thing that I wanted were two things: either my money back or justice. So, I mean, the guy spent like 2 days in the cell. I remember not even going there for those 2 days. And yeah, I was battling it. So how does forgiveness look like? So am I a bad person because I've gotten the guy arrested? Should I let it go? The fact that I had said I'd forgiven him and I'm still pursuing, how does that even look like? The fact that I had said that I've forgiven him but I'm still feeling this upset and I'm still feeling this mad, does that mean I haven't really forgiven him? Like, I was really going through a rough patch over there. So I didn't go to Kamukunji's to even have conversations. I was not interested in any conversation. I just wanted either my money or this guy locked up. Those were the only two things. Either one of those two things I was gonna take. So the guy actually thought that I wouldn't pursue this thing to court because he knows that the process can be tedious and long, which is true. And also, going to court means that it can also mean that I will never get my money back. Going to court means that, you know, I can't get justice twice. So I can't be locked up and I still get paid. So he knew that maybe I wouldn't want to go that way because that means I would lose my money. So what he was trying to do is chaser those mchezos of he wants to give me a little money, like maybe a quarter of how much money he'd taken from me. And then he says, oh, to Andikiane, and then you will find me. And then I was like, if it took us almost a month to arrest this guy, where am I going to get him to Kiandikiana? Like, how is that going even to work? Am I going to be calling him? Is he going to change his number? I wasn't going to do that. So that's the route that he thought I would take. Like, I would just kubali to take like just a little bit of my money back and then let it go. But wakeji ni nani? I was like, no. I was so determined, you guys. Okay, maybe I was being fueled by the anger. But I was so determined to see this thing to the end. So I decided, you know what, because, you know, someone cannot be arrested more than 48 hours and held in a cell. They actually have to be taken and presented in the court. So day one of court case came. And I remember going to court, and I remember him being presented before the magistrate, and he was cuffed. And I think at that moment, it actually dawned on him that this mama is not going to let this go, and she's so determined she's going to actually get me locked up. So I think inside him, he made that decision, like it was a quiet decision someone makes. He made a quiet decision to actually pay me the full amount. So what happens is that when you go to court, they give you 2 weeks. So you're presented in court. I don't know, they call it what? Being arraigned in court. And then they give you 2 weeks, and they're hoping that in those 2 weeks you will have sorted yourselves, or rather sorted your issue outside of court. So by the time you come back, you only come back to withdraw the case. So within those 2 weeks that now were given, that guy had paid me all my money, and the only thing that was remaining was to go and withdraw the case. So today, sitting here, 4 months later, it took 4 months for me to withdraw the case because COVID happens. I mean, the third wave, there was another lockdown. So, I mean, Makadara is not going to do virtual courts. I think the cases there are so dramatic, they can't do virtual. The cases are dramatic. really dramatic. So anyway, so it took 4 months, but I can happily say that I have been fully paid of every shilling that I had given to that guy. And that case, I can call it closed. Super, super closed. And I'm so excited that I pursued legal justice. I'm so excited that I didn't let go. But these are some of the things that I learned. Lesson number one, not a very serious one, but a lesson number one. If your life has no drama and you're looking to put some drama in your life, imagine, just go and sit in a court. The drama in that place. Ay, you guys. Like, most of the time I just sat there. Because I went to court like maybe like 4 times. Every time I would go to withdraw the case, what? Let me tell you. Stories after stories. But the thing is, every time I would sit in court, there would be so many dramatic cases. Most of the time I would be like, I'm this close to bursting out in laughter. But I remember that cuffs don't look so good on me. So I would keep quiet, I would state myself, you know, contain yourself. So anyway, that's one thing that I learned, that there are so many dramatic cases. There's so much happening in courts. I mean, there were like so many courts happening at the same time, because I mean the courts were happening in like intense. There's so many cases happening, and that is just one place. That's just Makadara courts of law. But anyway, the other thing that I learned is this, is that forgiveness does not necessarily mean that pain will go away right there and then. Forgiveness does not necessarily mean that you should not pursue legal justice. Forgiveness does not necessarily mean that now, after you've said you've forgiven someone, that you will not feel anything, that thing is now, it's like over and done with. No. Forgiveness is basically saying, I have forgiven this person. That even if I'm pursuing legal justice, I have actually forgiven this person. I'm pursuing it because I want my money back. Or I'm pursuing it because I want justice. But kwa roho yangu mimi nimesamehe huo mtu. The other thing that I learned is that pursuing legal justice does not necessarily mean that you have not forgiven someone. But if pursuing legal justice or the process is going to do you more harm than good, that if the process is going to, you know, cause you mental illness of some sort, let me tell you, the process can be really tedious as well. And even just having to follow up with someone every time you see that person and the person has hurt you, because I mean I'm not just talking about money, you could have been hurt in a different way, so that it means that every time you see that person you kind of just bring up the wounds again. It's not necessarily important. You can actually let it go. You can let go the pursuing. You can let go pursuing legal justice, and it does not mean that you are weak. It does not mean that you are a sissy. It does not mean that you are defeated. It just means that you are strong enough to have chosen yourself and to have chosen your sanity. And, you know, just to say to let go, there are people who have swindled me of more money than even this guy have, and I've let it go because I realized that pursuing it would actually cause me more harm than good. So anyway, having told you that story, I'm so glad it ended well, and I'm so glad that I got the money back. I'm so glad that, you know, that the pain I felt and the anger that I felt and the having to go through all those emotions was not in vain. But I think for me, the challenge that I would want to challenge each and every one of us, every one of us who could probably, you probably have been hurt by your parents, you probably have been hurt by your spouse, you probably have been hurt by, you know, a colleague, your boss, it could be even your children. I mean, sometimes children can really behave badly and forget that you gave birth to them. And sometimes it could even just be a friend who you really trusted and they hurt you. For me, my challenge is and will always be forgive. And not because they deserve it. Sometimes those people don't deserve that forgiveness. But because forgiveness will free you. Not to say necessarily that the pain will end immediately you decide to forgive, but eventually it will free you. Eventually you stop feeling the pain. Eventually you stop thinking about it. Eventually the pain actually ishas, like you stop feeling that pain completely. And forgiveness is the only way. Because I mean, if you don't forgive someone, then you'll be feeling pain all the time. You'll have bitterness all the time. You live your life an angry person. And even worse enough, you'll make your prayers not be answered. There's a whole verse about it. Me, I was just like, me, I have to forgive people. There's no other things I'm praying for, I'm not getting because I didn't forgive someone. And the other thing that I would like to say is that forgiveness is not complicated. wanted. Sometimes we complicate it because we think that maybe when you forgive, you must stop feeling the pain immediately, or when you forgive means that you have to be friends with that person. No, forgiveness is not complicated. Forgiveness is just deciding in your heart that you're going to forgive that person and saying it out loud. Not necessarily saying it to the person who offended you, but just saying it out loud and saying, I forgive this person, I forgive so and so because of what they did, because of this and that. That is it. And every time anger comes back again, every time you feel like, I thought I forgave this person, but I'm kind of feeling, you know, kind of feeling cowardice, I'm kind of feeling angry, I'm kind of feeling this, just go through that whole process again. Just say, I forgive this person for this and this that they did to me. And then you leave the rest to God, who is an amazing healer. God is an amazing healer of things that, you know, like heart, our heart and our emotions. God is an amazing healer of that. So you just do your part, which is forgiving. Say it out loud. Sometimes saying it helps for you to actually believe it, that you have actually forgiven that person. And keep saying it. Every time anger comes up, just say it again. Just keep forgiving until one day you wake up and you're like, by the way, this thing doesn't hurt anymore. So that will be my challenge for you. That's my challenge that I'm leaving you with. And I'd like to still leave you with a verse that I spoke about last time. A verse that I wasn't very ready to listen to at that specific time because I was going through really a hard time. And I'm just going to read it. It's in Romans chapter 12, verse 17 to 19. I'm going to read from the easy to read version because it's easy to read. So it says, if someone does you wrong, don't try to pay them back by hurting them. Try to do what everyone thinks is right. Do the best you can to live in peace with everyone. My friends, I like the fact that Jesus called us my friends after he's about to tell us some really difficult truths. He says, my friends, don't try to punish anyone who does wrong to you. Wait for God to punish them with his anger. Do you think your anger is like a lot? God's anger is like the worst. Sometimes I'm just like, well, I'm not even sure I want that person to be punished by God. Because man, it's gonna be hard. Like, it's going to be like the consequences of whatever it is that they did, if they don't say, you know, I'm sorry, or if they don't repent, is really bad. It's like it's really, really bad. So he says, wait for God to punish them with his anger, because in the scripture the Lord says, I am the one who punishes. I will pay people back. This is Romans chapter 12, verse 17 to 19. It's a verse that spoke to me in that season. It's a verse that has continued to speak to me even in this season. And even between then and then, there has been other things that have happened that I've needed to forgive, because, I mean, we live in this world and people will continually hurt you. So it's good to just learn to forgive, learn to just let go of stuff, so then you're not carrying it and you're not bitter all the time and you're not stopping your blessings from coming because you're carrying bitterness. So anyway, thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for Yanni. I'm so glad that you guys came. And I'm so happy that that case is closed. And now that chapter is closed. So we can move on and resume to doing happy videos. We can resume to doing videos that are full of... By the way, I want to do videos that are full of testimony. So you guys, if you have a testimony out there and you really want to share it, hit me up. Like, I'm really ready to just do testimonies. Because I feel like testimonies are really edifying. And they really can encourage someone who's in such a space. So yes, thank you so much for watching. I pray that you share this video, that you subscribe, that you ask your friends to share and subscribe, and you stay tuned for whatever it is that is coming next. Thank you so much. Love you. Toodoo.